you shared about your disappointment yesterday. You also have outgoing Senator Richard Gordon, who shared his disappointment that his fellow senators didn't sign the Farmley Committee report. And what do you make of that?
Well, you know, we are a deliberative body.
Yeah.
Each of the 24 senators would have his own views. If they, if the point of contention was the finding that President Duterte committed an impeachable offense, and that is what where the line was drawn. Yeah. And you know, so the Senator Gordon did. Report did not get the support of the majority. But mind you, Karen, not everything is thrown to waste there. Number one, in the next Congress, a law can be passed abolishing the PSDBM and the PITC, because these were two vehicles used to commit a massive corruption, one of the biggest corruption deals I have seen in my career. The whole corruption in PSDBM started when the Secretary of Health Duque passed on $42 billion without any documentation.
You were the one who exposed the transfer of the funds. I think the public should remember that you found the transfer.
I did expose that as being contrary to law. You cannot treat this as your private funds and let somebody else spend what the Congress authorized you to spend. And that is, even if the committee report was that did not get majority support, this is a valid finding exposed to public scrutiny, and which the next president, Senate president, and Congress should look at closely. I have full confidence Senator Migzubiri, that he will lead his chamber in pursuing the results of the investigation. And there is nothing that will prevent the 19th Congress from again taking up the report. A resolution can be filed by any of the senators asking that the Blue Ribbon investigate. The next Blue Ribbon can adopt all the findings in the present Congress of the Blue Ribbon and present a new report for adoption.
Now, what you are leaving the Senate with? You're leaving the Senate with more families together. Meron ka ng I think meron kang magkapatid. Dalawa na magkapatid, the two Cayetanos, two Estradas. You have meron ka ring mag-ina, Villar. And if Jojo Binay won, you would have father and daughter. But that didn't happen. But you have families in the Senate. How does this affect really the independence of the Senate, the quality of the debate in the Senate, and even the thinking that goes into deliberation when you have too many family members there?
I would rather leave that to those who are there. But it's on record. Number one, I am the only Drilon in the elected as an elected public official. Nobody else had presented himself or herself. No other relative has presented himself to the public. Second, and most important, I was among the first to file a bill to implement the anti-dynasty provision in the Constitution. I filed this not because of the relationship of the senators found in the present Congress. I filed this several Congresses ago because I believe that, there are advantages in having an anti-dynasty law. Without in any way passing judgment on the ability of relatives to perform their task as elected representatives of the people.
No, okay. Now, minority is the next battleground. How important is it to form a strong minority in the Senate? And who do you believe should be Senate Minority Floor Leader?
First, the minority is very important in the Senate because it is an effective check and balance system. Even if there's only one opposition, because of the no rule to rule in the Senate, you can filibuster to block a bill. So you don't need that many. You just need somebody who is strong enough, competent enough to be able to debate and debate it forever if you want to block a piece of legislation. And this has happened in the past Senate.
So who do you believe should be the next Senate Minority Floor Leader?
Well, the only opposition candidate who won is
Senator Risa Ontiveros.
Risa Ontiveros. And therefore, by that circumstance, she should have a prior claim to the Senate opposition leader.
But I know that Senator, you know this as well, Senator Coco Pimentel is also gunning for that post.
Yes, Senator Coco Pimentel being a lawyer, having been a senator for quite a time, yes, he's qualified to take the cudgels for the minority. He has taken positions in the latter portion of his career in the Senate, opposite that of the administration, and he has shown his capability to be independent.
How many do you think, Senator Frank, just quickly, will be left in the minority? Because you have Senator Amy Marcos saying that there should be a super majority in the Senate.
I don't know what that means, but anyway, you're saying how many more? No.
Yeah, how many are left?
So we're talking about two so far, Risa and Coco. But when the media carried the posting of the different senators, one thing I noticed is that Pia Cayetano, who is the present chair of our Committee on Ways and Means, a very important committee, talks about taxes, will be replaced by Win Gatsalian. This is a very significant development, because the majority of senators would have a first crack on the major committees, and especially in the case of Senator Pia, he is an incumbent chair of the Committee on Ways and Means. The fact that he lost the committee to Win Gatsalian is an indication to me that he wants to join the minority.